Hey everybody, this is Rydo, and we are back with another recording of Hearthstone. So we are finally at the end. We've gone through Mage, Paladin, Priest, Warrior, Rogue, Hunter, Warlock, and Shaman. Now we just have Druid to rebuild their deck, and then we will have all of the deck rebuilds done for a while. Again, this is all started because of the solo adventure League of Explorers coming in and adding a few cards, very few cards, but it is a good excuse, and any excuse to rebuild your deck and reconsider the cards I've been playing is probably a good idea. I feel like I'm going to do better. So we have the Druid right now up. It's on the Hearthstone deck tracker app, so you can see that, and that will stay up for the rest of this recording, hopefully. This is about, I think, maybe increasing health, increasing character's attack, swipe, giving your hero some attack. It feels like this deck is kind of all over the board. Like, why do I have the recruiter in here? Why would I want a 2-2 squire in my hand? That's weird. Before we get to this, though, I also want to point out that I figured out how you can change the card backs. Unfortunately, it's kind of something you're never going to really use. So let's say I want the classic card back here. You click on it, or you drag it, or you do whatever you want really to it, and it's done. That's all you have to do. But the truth of the matter is, what's going to happen is when you go over here to this and you find whatever newest one you've got, and I want to show it off to everybody, I'm going to come over here and make it favorite. And when I make it favorite, I believe it is going to come back and, oh, it doesn't change it. So that's kind of cool. And they even kind of indicated that, I guess, because there was, when I clicked on, like, this one, it's kind of faded out just as the default. So I think I will probably want to not have any default one, and I don't know how you could do that. This card may just be stuck with the Winter Wreath from now on until I delete this deck and start over again, which is going to be a slight problem because I did, for the Shaman, put a deck in here. So the Shaman, until I can delete that and rebuild that, which isn't going to be for a while, is going to have the Christmas card backs or whatever. Not a big deal. I think I just am not going to play with that. What I am going to play with right now is this. Let's see what we got for Druids. Because we're confused as to what even we want to do with a Druid. You're given a Raven Idol. It is a spell. It gives you a minion or a spell. Weird. Summon a random one cost minion. Okay. And both players have spell damage +2. And that's a beast. There's a lot of beasts here. Should I be playing a beast deck? Well, there's some thought to that. The hero ability of the Druid gives you +1 armor and +1 attack. How is that going to integrate to any cards, really? I have seen some strategies with the Druid to try and make the other player run out of cards. If you were going to make a deck like that, you could play this card. Play that card. Beasts. I think we need to focus more on beasts. Let's see what we don't have. What are the cards we don't have that might make more sense here? If we were just going to fill up on beast cards. probably not gonna play this one anymore. A lot of the cards have these opportunities where you choose one. And choose one, I don't know if I've seen choose ones on anything but druids. So, in theory, the ability to choose is always better than not the ability to choose. But, yeah. Still, I'm not sure. I'm still not sure. I'm just trying to wrap my head around druid cards. Come on, show up words. All the words, not just half the words. It gets worse too. It totally gets worse as we go. Choose one, deal two cards, or return five, restore five health. Shuffle this into your deck when it dies. Your minions cost one. I would totally have this in my deck. Tree of Life is restore both players back to full health. So if you play Reno Jackson and Tree of Life, you could potentially see how you could make the other player run out of cards faster. Maybe. Still not a great strategy though, that takes too long. Choose one, give your other minions +2/+2, or summon +2/+2 Trance with Taunt. There's a lot of Trance going on as far as the druid. That's not going to do anything for the druid, neither is that. You can use your hero power more than twice a turn. Sure, that would actually work quite well with the druid. No to that, no to that. You can't even get these, can't even get the words to pop up. It is so broken. I should have exited out of the program. Let's see. It's so broken. This is just memory leaks in the graphic textures file, I guess. Is what I assume is happening here, because it happens as we go on. It's really weird. I don't think it's my video card. That wouldn't make sense. My video card should not be so fragile that just recording Hearthstone for any duration, even though it has been several hours running, that doesn't make any sense that it would suddenly mess up whenever you play top three cards of your deck. I don't know why you would ever do that. What does this one say? Remove the top three cards of your deck. Is that the same as discard the top three cards of your deck? Why is it using the phrase remove when discard has been the established vernacular? If I use this with the Tiny Knight of Evil, will the Tiny Knight of Evil get stronger each time I remove the top three cards of my deck? If that's true, then the Tiny Knight of Evil suddenly has a great card to play with it. But that would be a Warlock deck, not a Druid deck. Leroy Jackson still. I wanted to see what mechs would look like in the Druid deck. I don't think they're gonna work. Add a random spell to your hand. No, that's no good. I can't even see half these cards, so summon a 4/5 something. No. No. Add a random paladin card to your hand. No. A better version of your spell ability? Sure. Same cards I say sure to every time. I mean, it's the same reasons. Those cards are the good cards. All the other cards are pretty much just bad cards. So it doesn't even matter if I don't get half of these legendary cards. If I get Dr. Boom, that's really all I need. And a few others. I'd like this pirate card. I'd like them to show up. I can only have one of them, so if they're a legendary card, so you, if I get a second one, it's just gonna get turned to dust, which is fine. Would I use the frost giant? Frost giant's a good candidate if I had it. Alright, so enough of messing with that because it's not even really working with me. Boy, I'm losing steam fast, as you can see. I can't even spell things right. There's two mechs here. Whenever a minion takes damage, add a spare part to your hand, and then this guy. And that's about it. So I think my druid deck is a mess right now, so let's just get rid of it to start with and make a new druid deck. So I want to try choose as a phrase. Maybe it's C-H-O-O-S-E? Yes. Yes, the phrase choose only shows up. The word choose only shows up here. Discover a minion, discover a spell. Alright, fine. Deal 2 damage or summon that. 2 of that. Deal 3 damage to a minion or 1 damage and draw a card. That one. That one. Plus 4 attack. That one. That one. That one. That one. That one, that one, that one, that one, that one. So that's 22 cards of just choosing. The next thing would be, do we want to play a couple of that? Destroy a minion, your opponent draws 2 cards. This is the only deck that really can do stuff like that. It's make it so you could... make it so you could potentially take a couple empty mana crystals. Gain a mana crystal, death rattle, leave a mana crystal. Sure. I don't think I would want to play this card. I think I'd much rather have the heal bot. That one, gain 10 mana crystals, discard your hand on the fourth turn. Interesting, we'll play that. Swipe. So now we need to start thinking. I'll get rid of dark that and that instead. I'll get rid of that. That. Let's see. I'll get rid of that one for that. Let's see. I'd get rid of this one for that one. Give a friendly beast +3 health. Inspire, give your hero +2 this turn. I think you want that. I'll get rid of that. One. Play that one. +4 attack, plus that. Take this. We'll get rid of that one, and then that one. Hmm. see, what else do we want? Cost one less for each minions that have died this turn. Now, whenever you summon a beast, reduce the cost of this card by one. Well, how many beasts are in this deck? Two. Not a lot right now. Recycle. Forces of nature. No. Okay, so let's get the heal bots in here. I guess that would be easier if I just typed in heal bot instead of heal. Let's see. Gain 2 mana crystal, deal 2 damage, or summon this. Let's get rid of that. Get rid of that. The Raven Idol is actually a stupid card. I'll just straight up tell you that. There's no reason to have that in the deck. So I want the dragon here. The dragon that gets +1/+1 every time you target it with a spell, I think might work quite well if I can find him. Where's that dragon? I'll find him. Don't worry. I'll find him. Here he is. So let's get one more of that guy in here. I could be wrong about having that guy in here, actually. Choose one. See, this is the only cards that would do that, actually. So, yeah, wouldn't be a great card to have, actually. So let's just take that back out. Who else would I want? How about that one? We'll throw that one in just for fun. But in all realisticness, we'd probably find something better to play. So this is all about options, whether you want to heal or attack. There's no real spells here that are going to increase. How about some Mukos champions instead? Charge and taunt. I'll take that one out. This is kind of just a straightforward get their attack up, but you really only get one options at it. You can get their health up, you can get their attack up once, and that's it. You get one chance at it. Now, since those are all battle cry things, if I could double battle cries or have a character that got +1 attack for every battle cry, that would be great. I don't believe there is a character out there in the neutral set that does that, though. So, yeah, let's try this druid deck out and see how it works. Here we go, druid. Of course, it's getting late now. 1:04 according to my clock in the morning. I'm running late, somewhat. I've really been doing kind of good lately about trying to go to sleep at a more reasonable time than 1 in the morning. But I wanted to get the last one in. You know, try to push myself to do one more recording.
Malfurion,
and I can feel myself mentally fading off to Never Never Land. So I may very well lose this game just by stupid move, stupid play. Deal 3 damage or deal 1 damage and draw a card. Well, I don't think I can play anything on the first turn. Right now. On the second turn I could play these, or I could deal 2 damage and draw a card, which is better than her Fire Blast. All that will do is do 1 damage alone. So in the turn here, let's try this. Deal 3 damage to a minion, or deal 1 damage to the face. So in a lot of ways this is 2 cards in 1. You've doubled the number of cards by having choices, and you have a lot of cards that are centered around actually making the opponent run out of cards. Why anybody would have a gold version of Light's Champion in their deck, I don't know.
Someday I'll be just like you.
Bathe
in flame.
In the turn. Druid of the Flame, almost never play that. I almost never choose that option. Destroy all minions and summon 2/2 trans to replace them. Okay. Interesting move. I guess that was a move on my part, really. Discard your hand, gain 10 mana crystals. Do I want to do that? Let's do it. Full mana crystals too.
For the wilds.
Interesting.
Fine.
What a card. I don't think most people would play that card, but definitely something intriguing about it. Let's see. Turn. Of course, now you see the downside of having 10 mana crystals. What does it matter? Unless you draw your next hand and you have a 10 cost creature to play, you're going to need to have some reason to play it. Let's see, deal 2 damage or silence a minion.
I must safeguard the land.
How about we silence a minion?
For the wild!
See what you can do now. I don't feel like this is a great deck right now. It feels very strange. I've never had great luck with the druid decks anyways though. It is my lowest creature. My lowest character. So I don't really know how to improve it. Let's see. Like this. Is this an improvement? Because that would be plus one plus that to get rid of two of that. And so I don't actually believe that is helpful.
For the wilds.
Let's just go ahead and try to get rid of this guy.
I dream and the world trembles.
Let's do this. Kill this. Do this. And end the turn. Emerald Drake. Ooh, this is not going well. This is not going well. Is this because of the
bathe in flames?
Snakes in absolute.
For the wild.
Job's done.
I've lost. I've been beaten by Legolas here, which I believe is a character from Lord of the Rings. Did I lose because of bad draw? Did I lose because I just have terrible cards? I can't even tell. So that's probably a great indication that I just have terrible, terrible cards selected. Maybe you put a pirate deck here. There really isn't a reason to. Maybe you play a Murloc deck here. There's not really a reason to there either. I don't think there's any pirates or Murloc decks that really work with the druid. But I just don't know what does. I'm not sure anybody does. I don't see very many people play with druids decks. And I certainly don't see very many people play well with druid decks.
Malfurion versus Thrall.
In a lot of ways, I think maybe the druid should have been the first character you played as, because it's so random and gives you so many options to play with that don't, at the end of the day, really matter. It would expose the new players a lot better to the game. Alright, let's try this. Play this, play this, go with attack, end the turn. Give a minion 4 attack or plus 4 health and taunt. Interesting. I don't know which way I'd want to go with that. I have 2 turns to figure it out though. Here we go. Summon a panther, attack there. So I could give this one 4 more attack or plus 4 health and taunt. I have to choose now. Let's see. So I will give him plus 4 attack, make him a 7, and hide him behind this taunt creature. And attack. End the turn. Deal 2 damage or silence a minion. Well, certainly I'd do deal 2 damage next turn. This is like the polar opposite of this game, though, of the last game.
Handle it.
Looks like I'm gonna easily beat the whole guy. I mean, this is probably impossible for him to catch up and win.
I must safeguard the land.
I assume I do 2 damage to this guy. That just has him at a 3 attack to face. He's down to 10 to 30. If he attacks this guy, which I assume he will, he'll probably attack my face, then attack this guy would be the right move. And then I can just nibble away at him, though. I mean, there's nothing he could do. If he doesn't kill this beast, I summon this, he becomes a 7-7. Plus 3 attack this turn, okay. Is he gonna hit my face again? No. That would be too dangerous for him. Deal 1 damage, freeze him? Alright. Bell the tip. Deal 1 damage and draw a card. Not gonna do that. Instead, I'll just play this and heal myself back up. Polar opposite of the last game. Just polar opposite.
Locked and loaded.
Completely dominating. I think it's because of the cards. And not just because this is a bad player. Let's see. Deal 2 damage or summon 2/1/1 samplings. Let's try deal 2 damage to this character. Deal 1 damage to this character, draw a card. The gain 2 mana crystal, gain an empty mana crystal, or do 1 armor and 1 attack. We'll just gain an empty mana crystal, I guess. And attack.
Nature's wrath.
End the turn. I'm not sure about the gaining the empty mana crystals.
I've got a huge
maybe all of that is just foolish and a waste. Maybe there are better cards out there that could be played, and there probably is. Actually, if I think about it, this one hits the face, and then we'll play this, and then this. And then end the turn. So, if he could turn this around, he could probably win. Still, he's not impossible to I'm not impossible to defeat. I've had to use all my cards.
Just me and Mr. Fight.
So, I gave him one outlet to win here, and let's see if my card becomes, let's see, this,
unleash the beast.
And then this,
snakes. It has done,
and then end the turn. Assumedly, he'll take these two to kill that guy. Then this guy would hit this guy, and I would only be able to hit him in the face once.
Handle it!
He could take all three of these guys to kill this guy, but then I could just attack with this guy. Or with my hero. Hmm.
Taz Dingo! Yes! Get in there and fight, maggot!
Well, he's filling up the board. Can he pull something off here?
There is little time.
Choose one charge or taunt. Let's see.
Where shall I strike?
Charge this. How many cards do I have left? 17. Charge
nature.
This.
For the wild.
Job done.
And then end the turn. He's got a 3-card advantage to me. I could have won right then. So not a perfect deck. Yeah, it's not like I'm growing more and more cards. I have too much mana crystals is really what I have. Too many mana crystals. Oddly enough, that's the real issue of it. Take this guy.
All the while.
Take this guy out.
Job done.
End the turn. Could have, of course, won there too. So I'm feeling like this deck is still like a few weak cards in here. Probably need to take the mana crystal stuff out. Find something better. Give a minion +4. Let's see, we'll give this guy +4 and taunt. We'll kill this character. We will kill this character. And we will kill this character.
Job's done.
And end the turn. He's got 15 more cards to figure out how to beat me. This is just so awesome though. I love when this happens.
Locked and loaded.
This is how I feel I should always be playing in Hearthstone. So if you ever feel like I'm being down on myself, this is why. This is what I feel like the game should be going on. There you go, Will. Go there. Oh, again, because one.
For the wild.
15 more turns. 15 more tries you've got. Figure something out. Just anything. Maybe I should start thinking about saving some cards and building up my hand.
Me and Mr. Fight.
Let's see. Nah. What would I want to do? Throw Muko's champion in here. This one. This one. See, I could take some damage there. But let's just go ahead and take some damage here. End the turn. Hmm. 12 cards. He could deck. I mean, I'll just let him deck. That'll be fine. Restore to full, give a taunt. Restore it full, give it taunt. Sure, why not? He has surrendered to my side. He's just saying, look, these are the cards I have. There was like nothing I could have played here. He's just showing me his entire hand. At this point.
You win this one.
Come on, you had 12 more cards. You couldn't think of anything to do? Guess you couldn't have. So we have one more victory needed for the druid. As far as quests go. That's not what we're doing today, but I have managed now to get one victory for the one left for Druid or Rogue, one left for Paladin. And so now is the right time to stop playing, because if I get one more victory for Druid, then that'll just be one more day I would have to, one day early, I'd have to come back and play regular play. So I just want to look at this card and let's see, think about what do I really want to get rid of. Gain an empty mana crystal, I think, is what I want to get rid of. I don't think you need it. I don't think gaining two this turn, you really need it. I don't think gaining 10 to discard your entire hand, you really need. So, with those out, let's start to look at some other cards. So the deck I just played, the deck that worked kind of fine. I took that out, let's see. I'll take two Mark of the Wilds. That's probably a good one. Take maybe this guy. Sure, he'll give me a mana crystal. And then these two sound good too. And then there, is there anything else that I'd really like? No, I don't really think so. And there's, whenever you summon a beast, reduce the cost of this card. No, that doesn't work. There's not enough beast in here. And I don't think there's anything here. Yeah, there's nothing really here that I would want. Maybe put an owl in here. Let's see. But no, because I have the other guy. This guy will silence a minion if I want it to. So I think I'm fine. I think I'm perfectly fine with the cards I have. I cannot think of anything else. So that's going to be my druid deck. And you will see me play that druid deck later on. We got the Tavern Brawl done. And next recording we will be doing the three quests. We are back to that. We have done all of our deck rebuilds. I hope you enjoyed it. It was long, I realize that. I really have to do it all at the same time in between a regular recording session, which tomorrow or earlier today, later today actually, I'll be doing a regular recording session. So that is it. As always, I ask you to like, share, subscribe, comment if you want to, and watch every second of my videos. All of that helps out. Let me know down below if you think I can improve any of my decks and what suggestions you have. Once we get up to 5150, we'll be doing arena runs again. So in maybe like 2 to 4 weeks of time, it should get somewhere around there, maybe a little bit longer. And then we'll be back to arena runs, and hopefully we can do multiple arena runs before they release a new expansion. If you want to support me, you can click on my name Rydo. On the right will be a blue button that says support this channel. Click it, make a donation. And if you want a friend to follow me on basically any social media sites, there's a whole bunch of links down below. Thank you for watching. Have a good evening.